Hello, this is Father Randy Sly with another installment of Day by Day in the Word. And today is Wednesday of the 16th week in Ordinary Time, and it's also a special feast day. Today is the Feast of Mary Magdalene. And so this is a very, very special day. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping. And as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary of Magdala went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and what he told her. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. There's probably no one in Scripture who has been more confused in terms of who this person is than Mary Magdalene or Mary of Magdala that we hear about here in the 20th chapter of John. And Mary has been confused with other women of the Bible. For example, she has been confused with the woman in Luke chapter 7 who was a known sinner. And so she has sometimes been relegated to being that sinful woman. Actually, the first appearance of Mary of Magdala was in Luke chapter 8, where it refers to the fact that she followed Jesus. She was one of his followers along with the 12, and there were three women that were listed, she being the first one. And it mentions the fact that she had been released from seven demons. So we know that Mary Magdalene was a woman from Magdala, which is a city in Galilee. And it was there that she was relieved and of the affliction, the demons that had been in her. And Jesus had, of course, cleansed her of those demons. And in response to this new life that she had, she began to follow after him. And obviously, from what we see in our reading from today, that Mary Magdalene stayed with Jesus the entire time. In fact, she was also with Mary, the mother of Jesus, and Mary, the wife of Clopas, at the cross. So she was one of the three women that was there with Jesus, along with the disciple whom Jesus loved. Of course, we know that was John. So Mary Magdalene is a woman who has little written about her, but plays a key role in Jesus' life, in his passion, his death, and then in his resurrection. Because not only was she there present at his death, and not only did she follow him during his life, where she was a witness to his miracles, she absorbed his teaching, she was a part of that apostolic company that went with him wherever he went, but also here in John chapter 20, we have Mary going to the tomb, and she's going there to help with some of the other women to prepare Jesus for the interment that would be permanent, that they were going to prepare his body with the burial spices that they didn't have a chance to do because of the Sabbath rest that they had to enter into after his death. So here it is Sunday morning. She's gone to the tomb. She finds the tomb empty. And it is at that point that she runs back and reports to Simon Peter and to John what had taken place. They run to the tomb, and obviously Mary ran after them, because we pick up the reading and there we see that she is there on the outside of the tomb weeping. And she bent to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there. And this is after the two disciples had returned back home after visiting the tomb. So Mary stayed there afterward. And it was during that time she looked in and saw the angels and had an exchange with them where they told her to, or asked her rather, what are you looking for? Why are you weeping? And she's, they've taken my Lord. And so anyway, it was at this point that she sees a person in the garden where the tomb is located. And she doesn't know that it's Jesus. But then, after she has that exchange with him again, where, sir, if you've carried him away, let me know where he is that I might take him. She wants to continue to prepare him. It's at that time that Jesus says to Mary Magdalene, Mary. And in looking at him, turning to look at him, she responds, Rabboni, teacher. In other words, it's at that moment that she realizes who it is that is before her, and she begins to hold on to him. But he cautions her not to do that, because he is not yet, he's in his glorified body, but has not ascended. And so the idea of her holding on to him is more of an idea of holding on to Jesus, not letting him go, rather than there being some kind of a forbidden thing going on. It's just that he realizes the fact that he is going, and he needs her to realize that this is just a temporary condition, that she is only going to see him for a while, and not to hold on to that because there's something else coming. And then, of course, at this, Mary of Magdala went and announced to the disciples, I have seen the Lord. And she began to tell them what he had told her. At this point, he had, of course, indicated that he wanted her to go and do just that, to tell them that, that he was there, and that he is going to the Father. To my Father and to your Father, as he says, to my God and to your God. Of course, just after her reporting this, what happens? Jesus appears to them as well, and they see the resurrected Lord. So Mary of Magdala shows up only in a couple places, but very key places. Wonderful encounters with our risen Lord, the first one to behold him and to take the message back to the disciples that he is risen. So may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts together be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, this has been good to have this day, especially a day of reflecting on St. Mary of Magdala, or Mary Magdalene. And it was just a few years ago that Pope Francis gave her own feast day. It was a memorial, but she was raised to a feast day because he recognizes that there is something very important that has to be gained and grasped about Mary Magdalene's place in Holy Scripture and her place in salvation history. And again, we don't want to confuse her with the other Marys. She is not, as I said before, the sinful woman of Luke chapter 7, nor is she the sister of Lazarus. Sometimes Mary Magdalene was also confused with Mary of Mary and Martha. That's Mary of Bethany. This is Mary of Magdala. So may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.